record button, like a fool.
Well, you get to record a little bit more than you stream. The archive will have a bonus.
Yeah.
Tune in. Patreon subscribers can get a extra 2 seconds of me streaming.
Of me accidentally pressing the start recording button instead of the start streaming button. You think we could beat this by tomorrow? Probably not, right?
Yeah, I don't think... I think Monday would be the day that I would target.
Okay.
But I guess because I don't know how fast this act will go since I did all the side stuff, so it might go by quicker. So okay. If we can get to Act 4 today, I think there's a good chance we finish it tomorrow.
Gotcha. Okay, we'll see. Because I think on Monday there's something else I'm going to stream just for a day.
Okay.
So then maybe we come back to it on Tuesday.
All right. Well, in the meantime, I'm ready to open this door when you are.
Here we go. Sorry, I was pressing buttons and whatnot.
That's this whole thing, man. Just pressing buttons and whatnot.
Oh my gosh, it is. You're right.
Yeah.
Hey, Adam Walker, maybe. Texas Ranger. Turn this thing.
Just call that. That's what you should call the stream, actually. Just pressing buttons and whatnot.
Just pushing buttons.
What's that? You ever watch Garkmanji's Dark Place?
No, I haven't. I should, though, right?
It's great, but there's a quote where he's like basically a more egotistical, I guess, as Stephen King. And there's like, they'll cut, it's like this weird show where they're, it's like a lost show from the 80s that they brought back because they were in dire need of programming. So he's like this really dumb, kind of like egocentric guy. And so one of his quotes is like, anybody can type keys on a keyboard. Getting him in the right order.
It's pretty good. Isn't that show like hard to watch now in a weird way?
I went to visit a few of my friends recently, and we watched like 3 episodes of it, and I still think the first episode is like the best encapsulation of what they're trying to do. So I don't know that like the later episodes are as good, but I still think that first episode was up tremendously well. Because it is like, it's what a lot of people are doing now, where it's a faux 80s show.
Oh, like it takes place in the 80s but was not made in the 80s, kind of.
Yeah.
Like Stranger Things.
There's a lot of good jokes in there.
Why can't I throw this grenade? Jeez.
Oh yeah, we get some points thought that it's Style Hilliard today.
Oh yeah. Style Hilliard. I remembered. I totally forgot last week.
I meant to pick you up, but instead I picked up ammo, which we all know is more important.
Well, you know, you need ammo. We talked about the importance of ammo on that first stream. Mm-hmm. How we need more of it, and a frequent, you know, consistent stream of it.
There's no shame in getting ammo, you know, however you can get it. Down and nobody's helping me.
Oh, are you?
I'm between two people. Okay.
Oh, you got it? I was about to say, remember, I don't get an alert on screen, so you gotta.
It's weird that they can. Like, I feel like. I don't know if it's just for this entry or what, but I feel like in previous games when people were down, I feel like the game made you more aware of it, but I might be.
I keep, like, I'm moving up too much, is my problem here.
Yeah.
I have a drop shot whenever we can get rid of this. Okay, there we go. Let me get to a safe zone. Get out of the way, dude. Alright, let's see. It was Foz getting in my way. Alright, let's see. I got 4 drop shots. Let me see if I can do some damage here. I let it go way. Oh, are you down?
No.
Okay. That's just the AI.
JD is.
Man, I am bad at using the drop shot. Jeez. I guess I'm just like, I'm not letting go quick enough or something.
I wonder if there's a delay between when you let it go and it actually explodes. There's a little bit of momentum on it.
I mean, that's what I thought, but even still, it feels like I'm still,
There's a bone. That bone.
God, I totally wasted those drop shots. I feel like I didn't do anything. it's more ammo.
Sweet. I know all about that, man. That face when need more ammo.
There we go.
I'm just now basically out of ammo, but we did it.
Come on, let's get that train turned around.
You can get the breaker mace.
You can have it. I don't want it.
I don't want it either. I got a lancer with 20 shots in it.
I was able to get a claw. That's about it. Yeah, I have 129 shots in this claw, and that's it. Fuck, there's anything.
Hey, someone want to help with this?
I've been looking at the chat. Glad I programmer Kyle telling giving me tips. Gotta write down, get ammo. Okay, we should be using Jack more.
That's fair. Yeah.
Let's see. What do I have? Assault? Do I? Okay, flash. All right. Oh, here's some ammo. Found some ammo. What's that? Did I take all the ammo? Jack, I should.
There's one here. I'm gonna take this.
I have not been upgrading Jack at all. Let's see.
Well, give me some electronic coins then.
Yeah.
It's a big truck.
Beautiful. All that's left now is to get it back to the hangar.
Train's a step ahead of us.
Come on, we can catch up to it in the skiff.
Should've just gotten on the train.
It's skiff time.
I'm driving.
Yeah. Getting away. You on, might have to get on the skiff. Yeah, because it was buried underneath the ground for me, so.
What do you mean, to be on that
skiff? I could see the little parachute, but nothing else.
I assume this is like a little chase sequence, right?
All right, everyone, hold on.
Yeah, I think you just need to get over the, yeah. I don't know that you have to. I don't know how timely you have to be, but.
Paddock, Baird! The rocket's on a train heading for the hangar!
Wait, what? It won't make it! The bridge has to be lost!
Uh oh.
Can't your people do it?
They're not there anymore! Why did you send the train back without lowering the bridge?
Because we didn't. Oh, forget it, we'll lower it ourselves!
I didn't know we had to lower it.
Well, you know now. No excuse, Kyle.
Hey, we gotta get
in the passenger seat.
What do you think I'm
little
doing?
Virtual tour.
Ah!
Wow, look at that non-threatening lightning. Turning all this sand into crystal trees.
I didn't even realize that was the result of the lightning. That's cool. I'm into that. Alright, that's the bridge,
the
right?
We're coming from.
I don't know, I didn't realize they were popping up. I thought they were just already there. I see now. I see that I was wrong. Skiff harder.
It's really all you can do. You gotta press, you gotta make sure you don't have the hair trigger on your Xbox. Push it all the way down. Do you have an Elite?
Controller?
Yeah.
No.
I've always kind of wanted one, and I've messed around with a couple of like the third-party solutions to those. And those are like, there's something about the fact that they're not the actual controller that always feels like there's just a lack of compatibility. So
yeah,
I had one for PS4 for a little bit, and that one just doesn't. I don't think turns on the PlayStation, and that feels like a deal breaker.
Oh,
where it's
weird.
Like, if this can't be my one and only solution to just having the if this can't be my one controller that I use all the time, I don't know that there's really a point. And those extra buttons, I haven't learned how to use them appropriately.
Yeah.
It's not like a thing where it's like, oh yeah, I'm saving inputs or whatever, and I can move faster like a pro gamer. I'm not at the point in anything really that where I'm like, I need to optimize my movement, the movements of my hands to move.
Yeah. Oh, I died. I just like sprinted ahead.
Oh.
Yeah, I keep looking at those Elite controller. I really like it. It's expensive, obviously, but like, I just like, I really want like a nice sturdy one that'll last a while, and like, I also like that you can pull the control sticks out just for as like a something to fiddle with while I'm while I'm waiting for load screens and stuff, which is like so weird. It's just like, I love things I can mess with like that, like additional buttons. Like, I'm always pressing all the buttons while the games are loading and stuff.
Well, might I? Aren't there those controllers for like those fake controllers for kids, where it's like you can give them a controller and it works like one?
Well, I mean, it's just an unplugged controller, right? I mean, that's what it is.
Yeah, but if it's like you only want to spend $10 instead of potentially breaking your, what I'm saying is that I know what I'm gonna get you for Christmas, Kyle.
You know, it's funny. My kid never fell for that.
No, you'd give her the controller.
I'd give her an unplugged controller, and she was just like, "No, this is not. I know what you're trying to do here." Like, even when she was super little.
That the fact that you think so little of me.
I mean, honestly, yeah, it was funny.
The bridge controls are wrecked.
Uh-oh. Bring it down the old-fashioned way. Grab that salvo. By shooting it, or is it? Oh, I'm doing this.
Okay. What the hell am I
shooting at? You have to shoot the those yellow clamps. That's fine, Foz. You can just get in my way.
How many times do I have to shoot this thing? All right.
Got it. It's coming down.
Oh, I just had to shoot the one side. Okay.
Well, I shot the other one.
Oh, you did. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I cut it a little close. Sorry, I didn't. Should have given you credit for the work you were doing there. Let's just get back to the
stick. As long as you eventually did give me credit, so.
Juvie cries.
Do you need, if anyone else out there needs someone to help them out with shooting that thing, just hit me up on Twitter. you can find my Twitch handle at a clever cadaver.
At Suriel Vasquez, right?
I'll do it freelance. Yeah, that's fine.
I'll ghostwrite the.
I will ride the skiff with you for $25. For $50, I'll destroy it, and then for $100, I'll just do it on hard.
Oh, $100, huh?
I'm a real gamer. I can't get on the skiff for some reason.
Yeah, I think I have to wait for the other guys.
I have this thing on there. Or maybe there's story going on. No, let's just get back on the skiff.
I think we just have to kill everything.
Okay. Oh, there's bad guys out here.
Oh boy. I'm low on ammunition. Give me your guns.
That guy just came out of the ground. I don't know if that was intentional or if it was a glitch.
Well, they are like underground monsters, right? Isn't that the idea?
Yeah. That guy was just hiding in the sand.
Oh, yeah, they're coming out of the sand.
Okay.
That's normal. I mean, it's weird, but
yeah,
it's supposed to be happening.
And they're all naked.
We got them all? Oh, no.
Think that's it?
I'm gonna grab some of this ammo. There's a lot of Lancers around.
Yeah, that's true. Just what I
need. Alright, I'm all full up. Did we get on this thing yet? Nope. What are we waiting on here?
Is there another enemy nearby?
Is there one up? Were you just... That might have been the AI shooting up there. Is there like a sniper up there or something?
Let's go find out. I mean, he's still up here.
Oh, there's a pouncer up here. Okay, I see it. He shot me.
Don't do that.
Surely that's all we needed to do.
Music settles.
I got an achievement. Cutting it close.
I think that's for the, I think a story one for the rocket?
Yeah, I think so.
You want to ride or should I?
I'll drive.
Oh. Okay.
What's up?
Well, I'm not on the skiff.
Where are you going?
You guys all disappeared.
Where are you going, dude?
I don't know what happened.
What does your screen look like? Because to me, it just looks like you're running off into the desert.
Okay, so when you got on the skiff, all of you guys flew over here. And now the skiff is here. And then all you guys vanished. And now you're all over there. Did you get out of the skiff at some point?
So, all right, because to me, like, you can even look at the stream if you haven't pulled up. Like, there's nothing here, dude. Like, you're losing your mind. There's a skiff right here for you.
Yeah, and there's the prompt and everything, but I can't, you're right, I can't get into the skiff.
Well, here, do you want to try walk over where I am? Let's see if this works. Let's see if a prompt appears.
You just disappeared.
I just disappeared?
Oh, okay, so I ran up to it, pressed X, and now I've teleported to the skiff where I said it was, and then back over here, and now it's spawned. So I think we've coalesced the timelines correctly.
Anyone else surprised by the size of that rocket? It's massive.
And now we can go.
Oh wait, why did I stop moving? I was looking at the map.
You need to accommodate atmospheric drag? No, I don't. Well,
Sluggo Jones is watching on YouTube, leaving us all kinds of comments. Thank you.
Scrubula says, like, I see this is one of the game's hilarious prank glitches. It's good.
Alright, let's see. I'm trying to figure out where to go. Maybe I should let you drive.
I'm trying to see where the map is. So I think we're gonna have to go around, basically. So, like, okay. You see that red marker I put in?
On the map? Oh, I gotta go that way?
I think so. Either that or...
I can go under here.
Okay.
Does that seem like a good way?
I think you're going to a side thing.
I don't want to do side things. I just want to do story.
So I think... I want to say... That might be a way in. But... Yeah, the map is a little weird.
Alright, let's see.
Actually, hold on. Get to the training facility. So I think you're... You're going to want to turn around, but go the up the higher route, basically.
Okay.
I'm looking at the map here.
So I'd be turning right here?
Yeah. Looks I'm watching like you rocks. Go on the map. This is very fun.
All right, I don't want to stop. This is because they're saying there's something up ahead. This is like a side quest deal, right?
Right. And then do a UE, yeah.
Okay. This feels right?
Yeah, and then keep going up that side. I think you'll hit a side thing on the way there, but you should just run past it. So then keep going until you see a fork, and then go left.
Okay. Yeah, this seems like we're going the right way.
So, Kate, your headaches. They're really gone?
Yeah. As soon as we killed the matriarch, they ended. Haven't had one since.
And this idea you have about your mother being...
It's not
try to go
idea.
Up. Yeah,
I
you're going the right
her.
Way.
Cool.
And just keep hugging left, yeah. Unless I totally miscalculated and there's like a hard cutoff here. But yeah, just keep going.
Yeah, it looks...
Yeah, keep going past the water tower.
And then just loop around it on the left.
Yeah.
I like that the team's like, Kate, should we do this? And I'm just like, nope.
We don't have time.
Uh-oh.
Can you keep going there? That way?
Let's see, is there a... Oh, I can go up here. There we go. Right, I think this is it.
Looking good.
Alright,
yeah.
Obviously,
and then just
no thanks to me.
Left here.
Meanwhile, I often wonder who stuck
there we go.
Stick up her ass.
You did it, Suriel. You navigated. Probably should have just let you drive to begin with.
Well, I had to go into the map menu to help you out, so...
No, I guess that's true.
You would have had to have been on map duty. Depends on how comfortable you are with maps.
I like the song Maps by the Yeah Yeah Yeahs.
That is a good song.
It is a good song.
That whole album.
Yeah,
great
album.
I think Karen O just released like a solo album and it's pretty good.
Are they still are they still a band? Or are they done? And it's a lot of Karen O solo stuff. I know she's working with like Spike Jonze a lot and doing like movie soundtracks and stuff.
Yeah, like she just had a solo album this year and it was good. It's very different, but
I'll check it out.
It's a little more low key, but she's not doing like a lot of her like high pitched
wailing and screaming.
Yeah,
I love that stuff though. Just like the
it's very yeah. But it's still good. It, like it's a good album.
I'll listen to it.
All right, so we're in the facility.
Okay, Paddock. We're here.
Don't know if we'll make it to the end of this act today, but I think we're gonna cut it close.
All
right. That computer virus locked us out of every building before I could get to them. And until your mod deals with that, you won't get to them either.
You hear that, buddy? I think it's in your tiny metal hands.
I wanna say there's a vent here somewhere that we need to have Jack go through.
Jack. Found it?
Yeah. You know, I remember it because I got stuck here for a little bit, trying to figure out where the vent was.
The centrifuge building. The beacons were most likely hidden there.
Centrifuge. Got it.
Okay. I'm just gonna upgrade Jack's core passive stuff.
Facilities activating, Delta.
Alright.
I knew Jack could do it. No sweat.
Paddock, Jack cracked the virus. We're in.
And you now have full access to the
I don't think that's how... Do you think actual hackers would use terms like, oh yeah, he cracked the virus.
And storm or no storm?
God, no.
We're heading over there.
That's not a good sign.
Although, if like, I feel like if you got into... if you were like a, let's say, a non-professional hacker who's just like hacking for the fun of it...
Amateur hacker.
Yeah, if you were like... You, if you're the type of person who want to do that, like I imagine you wouldn't be too far removed from using terms like crack your virus, or like using it ironically or something.
Yeah, that's a good point.
And then eventually, like coming to embrace it, because that's what happens with irony. You eventually actually embrace it. Using irony as the distancing mechanism.
I always used to say, like word, like as like a sort of acknowledgement. Like someone would say, like, "Hey, we're gonna go to the store tonight." I'd be like, "Word." And I would always say it as like an ironic joke, but now it's just like part of my lexicon, and it's like my actual like, this is how I confirm things.
I'll take that.
Right. The hallway filled with guys.
Well, you called it. Look who's here.
You got a scion.
Not for long. Because we're the Gears. Is that what they say?
that's their theme song, we're the Gears.
We're the Gears and we're here to fight.
I'm Marcus Phoenix and I'm here to say...
I hate Gear. I hate the bad guys.
Says, aw, damn. Son, I'm about to drop a sick rhyme. I don't know where that came from. That's not Marcus. That's not the Marcus I know.
Man, you know, when you start freestyling, sometimes it just, you know, it's just, you can't, you just gotta go with it, you know?
Yeah. There's that weird, like, meme that's come up after Gears 4 about Marcus being very concerned about his tomatoes.
His tomatoes?
Yeah, because, like, there's a part in Gears 4 where you go to Marcus's, like, house.
His house, yeah.
Yeah, and there's a fight where you're shooting at Locust over his tomato field.
Yeah.
He gets really mad about it.
That's pretty good. That's funny. But no references or anything to it in 5?
Yeah. Not that I know of.
There's that thing
like
that in...
Oh, go ahead.
I was just gonna... There's that weird thing in Gears 2 where you could find that toaster. Like, in the... Like, it was, like, underground and some, like, you know, inside the monster or something like that. It was just this toaster. And you, if you go up to it and, like, hit X, Marcus just goes, "Who wants toast?" What?
Yeah, that and the tomato thing were like the only times they really ever made an attempt to humanize Marcus. It's like more than like, oh, he's a father now. He's an adult who cares about things. Yeah.
Sometimes he takes off his do-rag. This is a very bland like shootout. I don't know. I'm just like,
That guy's got a lot of health and you gotta wear him down.
Yeah, it's just like, well, that took a while, I guess.
Well, I can do this. Got back cover. Now it's horizontal.
Is that bad guy?
Hold on, it's been too long since I changed off.
That was actually the perfect, like, from my perspective, it was like, hold on, I got chainsaw guy, and then you just, like, sort of walked into the frame, it was, like, perfect.
This is all Koro Gera, by the way. We actually played through this chapter already, we just do it again, so we get it right this time, you know?
Yeah, sometimes, you know, the recording doesn't work, and you gotta
redo
things.
We had a good rehearsal.
Oh, hard shell spaces? How advanced was the UIR space program?
This reminds me of, I was watching a Destiny lore video, and I totally forgot that the first thing that they really showed of Destiny was like a fairly like something that happened in the present, right? Like it was a exploration to Mars where they brought in like the U.S. and China and Russia, and like I had totally forgotten how grounded the origins of Destiny were, where it was like, oh yeah, we're exploring Mars. And then they found the Traveler, which is basically like a giant omnipresent thing.
Yeah.
Like, oh, right, I totally forgot about that. This was how they kind of started their pitch on Destiny. And that was like, that is so far removed from what Destiny is now.
Yeah. Yeah, like those sort of early ideas were like, it's going to be in our solar system, you know? But like, I mean,
it is, but it's like, it's on the, we're on the moon and Earth and stuff, but like, it definitely felt when they were pitching it early on, it felt like it was going to be a lot more grounded than it is now, where it's basically like, it may as well be like Star Wars with more guns.
Yeah. Well, I remember the funny thing about that when you start Destiny 1, you get that little cutscene of like, you know, yeah, the humans traveling to Mars and stuff.
Yeah.
But they have guns with them.
That's true,
like,
yeah.
Why do you have guns with you, like, if you're just, you know, exploring Mars?
You never know how these negotiations are going to go, okay? Yeah.
That just always struck me as odd, that they just had, like, what almost looked like borderline NASA astronauts, like,
yeah.
Oh, but they just have assault rifles with them.
I want to say there might be a set in the game that is very astronaut-looking, but I don't know if it was a reference to that or if they just happened to make a set that made you look like an astronaut.
So we gotta find where to send Jack, I guess, right, is the idea here.
Yeah.
It's like a portal puzzle. You just have to find the right angle to fire off the thing.
All right, Jack. Let's do it again.
I got it.
Did you throw something?
Just throwing stuff.
How early in development do you think they came up with the idea of Red Stand? Of like, dude, it's Red Snow. We can do all the same cool looking tech stuff.
I went to go try to
chainsaw, and then
so your brother Nate Zelli, that's your brother, right?
Yeah,
he's saying that they knew the Traveler was on Mars, I guess. Apparently.
I guess they were getting a signal. Yeah,
but even still, I don't know, did they just knew it was like a threat? I don't know,
they knew there was something on Mars. Yeah, they sent the Three Nations astronauts to check it out. Yeah. Yeah, it is pretty big, the Traveler.
Has that thing opened up yet in the story of Destiny? I know it's inside
the Traveler.
That thing?
Yeah. Well, like in 2, it got cracked open by Gaul, and they haven't really mentioned it much since then. Like everyone, like all the bad guys you meet are like, yeah, like the light of your Traveler is a phony or whatever, and that's kind of a little bit part of Shadowkeep, but I don't know. It feels like they've definitely put the Traveler in the back burner as like a key player in the universe, beyond the fact that he like basically powers all the Guardians with light, kind of his whole its whole thing.
But it's still like just like a big mystery, right? Like no one really knows what the thing
is,
right?
The more you read about it, the more it's just like, hey, it's basically that whole speech at the end of True Detective Season 1 where he's like, well, the light is battling against the darkness. So that's really the major conflict here, but you know they've moved away from trying to name the darkness as like the central bad guy and trying to give it a face.
Yeah.
I like taken a whole lot. I don't know that Shadow Team exists. Interesting to me, but I'm still having fun with it. Is that all of them?
Yeah, I had a grenade ready to go, so.
Okay.
Since I was killed by them last time because I was trying to, like, go chainsaw them and stuff. Because I got jealous of your chainsaw action. I assume we can climb up there, right?
That's what I thought.
No?
We have to lower this thing.
Oh. You got it?
Get in there, Jack.
Master Resistance says they need to make the Traveler a playable area. Wouldn't that just be like a big white flat area with no cover, probably?
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know. I guess
if it's like the last fight in like Destiny 3 or something where you have to fight someone on top of the Traveler. I could see that.
That'd be cool.
Well, at least not every DB turn.
Look at all these guys.
It's creepy.
On me! We can get through here! Look out! There it is! Almost at the centrifuge building!
Hang on! We gotta
storm! We're being... The storm is buffeting us. We have to yell to talk to each other. By the way, there's ammo over here!
Not for long.
In case anyone needs it.
These guys, they like to blow up, huh? That's fun.
Yeah. You ever blow up?
Nah, man.
It's fun.
They're down. Let's get inside.
I don't. Squiddle Willis is Kyle the Barney Stinson of gaming. Barney Stinson is like the creepy pervert guy from How I Met Your Mother, right? Like the womanizer. It seems like
I've never seen How I Met Your Mother, so I don't.
Yeah,
know.
Yeah, I don't think I want to beat him. I'll be Neil Patrick Harris, the person.
Oh, that's Neil Patrick Harris's character.
I think so.
Neil Patrick Harris plays a creepy pervert in How I Met Your Mother.
Yeah, well, he's like, you know, but it was like you know, 5 years ago or whatever, so it was like funny.
Instead of kind of shitty. And
now it just kind of is like, well, he's just lying to women a lot and being an asshole. I mean, a jerk. This is a Game Boy game. I don't know, I haven't watched enough of that show. I shouldn't make assumptions about it. Oh, just the suit, I guess they mean. Okay, yeah, I'll take that. I mean, Neil Patrick Harris, handsome man.
He's like a
man.
Character who wears a suit in that he wears a suit.
Yeah, he's like he's handsome and he wears a suit. So like, yeah, I'll take that. Hey,
ODD, I also like that they picked one guy to be the representative of all people who wear suits. May as well be Neil.
They got together. Agreed.
I'll be the me of television.
Can't believe that knack thing still works.
Adam Walker, Texas Ranger says, isn't Matt Hazard the Barney Stinson of gaming or something? What game was he in? That sounds right.
Yeah, Matt Eat Led the Return of Matt Hazard, I think, was the game. Which I was excited about only because Will Arnett is in it.
Yeah, I remember it was like, yeah, a comedy game starring Will Arnett. I'm all about that.
Yeah.
Seems like Will Arnett's actually a pretty big gamer in general. Like, I know he was a big Call of Duty guy.
Yeah. When I followed him for a little while, because I think with most celebrities, you follow him for a little while, it's like, yeah, I liked him in this thing. And then you realize, oh, they're kind of like, they're not going to post anything super crazy good to Twitter. Like,
yeah, they just tweet, hey, my show's premiering tonight. It's like, oh, okay,
yeah,
thanks.
I think. With him, it was a lot of, he watched a lot of NBA, so at some point I just have to say, okay.
I don't watch any NBA, so.
I like it better when you're a depressed force.
When's that show's coming back pretty soon, right?
Yeah, I think it's either the 13th or the 25th?
This is like two parts or something? Yeah, that's a great show.
Yeah. Alright, I'll wait for you to get off of that ledge.
These guys blow up, right? So I'm just being careful with them. Oh, maybe they don't blow up. Okay.
Well, they do blow up, but I think it's Something has to trigger it, I think. I don't think they just run that huge blow up. Alright, cool. We're the chainsaw. We're the chainsaw twins.
Chainsaw bros. Right. Chainsaw guys being chainsaw dudes. Flaming Queso says, Will Arnett is a terrific Batman. Agreed.
Yeah, he's a... I would love to listen to an audiobook of him. He has a really nice, like, very gravelly voice.
We'll have to discuss that later.
Like, he doesn't even have to lower his octave or anything to play the do the Batman.
Yeah, really. Did you ever see that? I think it was like a last year, maybe April 1st. They had that weird thing where Will Arnett was just like,
he was on like a Netflix thing.
Yeah, it was like they sort of like, it was like they pretended it was live. I mean, it wasn't really live, but like for the sake of the joke, they pretended it was live, and it was just him like watching security footage of the Netflix offices and commenting on it or something. I don't even remember.
I
remember thinking it was pretty funny though, and like watching it for a bit.
Yeah, I watched, I don't know if I mentioned this before, but like I watched that Netflix show Flake almost entirely because he was in it.
Yeah, I haven't really heard much about that. I mean, is it?
I think it ended after two seasons. It was okay.
Yeah.
It wasn't great. But it was Will Arnett and Venice. Like, it was in Venice, and like, I think that's in the Bay Area.
Mm.
So I was like, oh, I've never been there. That'd be nice. It was very touristy in that it showed off a lot of that area.
Gotcha. Kind of cool. If you watch that show on Netflix, it's one that I haven't heard a lot of people talking about, but it's like Christina Applegate, and it's called like Dead to Me.
Yes, I watched that. That's a good show.
It's so good. Like, I feel like it's not quite getting enough sort of, you know, hitting the zeitgeist enough. Like, it's super good.
Yeah. I wonder if it's just because it's not super popular in our circles. I don't know.
Maybe. Yeah, that could always be the thing. Yeah. I mean, people are really talking a lot about superhero stuff in our circles, it turns out.
Yeah.
That takes up most of their time, as there's like a top.
Yeah, I was pleasantly surprised by how good that show is.
Yeah. I mean, I like Christina Applegate, and the other woman I really like a lot, I can't remember her name. She's always great. But even still, I was like, I guess I kind of expected it to be like really just a bummer.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because it's like the initial premise of like, you know, she lost her husband. It's just like, oh, is this like just full on drama? Yeah. But I found myself laughing like
it is very
a surprising
like
amount.
Yeah. I'm surprised by how quickly it moves sort of beyond that basic premise. Cause the trailer kind of presents it as like it's going to be about grief counseling, and it's not really about that. Like the fact that they're. That she's bereaved plays into it a lot for sure, but it's not like.
Think it's look at these crazy people in this grief counseling group. It's like, oh, no, that's not what the show is about at all. Like, I don't even want to say what the show is actually about.
Yeah.
Because it is, they hold it till like the second episode, pretty much, you know?
Yeah.
But they pull that good place trick that I really admire, where it's like, they write themselves into corners. And it's like, well, how? Come on, how are you going to get out of this? You know?
And they very.
Where does this
like,
go? You know?
Oh, there's these two guys over here that are both trying to run up to their guy to get them to revive him. But the guy's just shooting at him.
That's one of my favorite things about a good place, as I've been, you know, watching since the first season was premiering, is like, I'm constantly like, okay, this is what the rest of the season's gonna be like. I see what this is what the show's about now. And it's like, it lasts like one episode, you know, before things move on and they go a completely different direction. It's like, oh, okay.
So I thought, especially at the start of season three, I thought like, okay, so they're going with a slightly different, like this is gonna be the premise of this show from at least this season.
Yeah.
And then it's like,
nope.
Apologies if we're inadvertently spoiling things for people, but I feel like we're talking around it okay.
Yeah, I don't think so. Watch Good Place if you haven't. The fourth season is on now, I think. I watched the first episode.
Yeah. We need Jack to verify the beacons are okay.
Come on.
Gotta secure these beacons. I want more Lancer ammo.
Just been sticking with Claw because it does have so much ammo. You can, and it feels like it does do a good amount of damage for how much ammo you get out of it.
I'll have my people transport them. Fine, but Delta, I need one here ASAP to get a head start on calibrating.
Adam Walker, Texas Ranger, asking about amazing cartoons, the great emotional range, BoJack, Avatar. Someone brought up Steven Universe, which I totally agree with. A super underrated show that, again, is like one I don't think a lot of people talk about when they talk about things like Steven Universe and stuff like that. Star versus the Forces of Evil is fantastic, and didn't really get the sort of, again, like, the, you know, the people talking about it enough, I don't think. But no, it's like, you can watch it on, like, Disney Channel or something. I ended up buying it all. Like, I think we watched the first season on Hulu, and I was like, this is great, and then, like, me and my wife and kid ended up just buying the seasons on Amazon as they came out and watching it that way. But that's like, kind of like Gravity Falls. Like, it's sort of like, it's not really similar to Gravity Falls, but it's like one of those things. It's like, if you like Gravity Falls, like, I think you'd like Star versus the Forces of Evil, you know?
Yeah. Okay. I watched a couple episodes of Gravity Falls, and I liked it. I just, it was a network thing, but
yeah,
ended up not being able to watch it.
That's a show that really is good throughout, but, like, really finds an impressive, like, oh, this is something special in, like, the last, like, you know, I don't know, 10 episodes or so.
Okay.
When they kind of, like, dig into, the like, the main plot, you know, and it's less of, like, Monster of the Week and more like, all right, here's the larger story, here's what's going on, you know?
Yeah.
And it's got J.K. Simmons in it.
I was
speaking of great voices.
I was surprised at how much star power was in Korra when I watched that.
Oh yeah.
Aubrey Plaza's in it. What's his name? The guy in Arrested Development who kind of hides places and is like the very, I'm a very serious lawyer guy.
Oh, Henry Winkler?
No, not Winkler. The guy they hired in like the first season or so to against him, and he's like, oh, I'm a no-nonsense lawyer, but I'm gonna like hide in the corner of this room to avoid being seen.
Oh yeah, God, what is that guy's name? He's in everything.
Yeah, he's in it.
Oh, jeez.
It's like pretty prominent characters too. It was pretty impressive.
I need to watch more Korra. I watched all of Avatar, but only watched the first season of Korra.
I think the first season of Korra is the best one. I think it's like better than any single season of Avatar, but I think Avatar as a show is probably better.
Yeah. Well, the threat of, like, the main threat of that first season of Korra, I think, is really effective. Of just, like, this person will prevent you from being able to use your abilities, you know, like.
Yeah.
That's like, scarier than death in some ways, you know, in that universe.
And I think, like, it kind of struggles with every season there's a big bad, but there's no overarching plotline to Korra.
Yeah.
It's just kind of her using her powers. There's no, like, major, like, there's not, like, the threat of the Fire Nation the way there was in.
Oh, like, that was just consistently, like.
Yeah. That was, like, the goal, the series ends when, you know, the Fire Nation.
Come on, let's get inside.
Right, so.
Spoiler.
Well, like, that was, that their whole thing was that, like, we need to stop the Fire Nation from defeating the Avatar and throwing the world into chaos. But that's, like, the thing that that show sets up. From, like, the first episode. But, like, so you have that, okay, we need to get to the Fire Nation is, like, the guiding thing, whereas Korra kind of meanders a lot more. Alright, so now we're gonna defend this place.
We gotta hold down the fort here.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're just talking about television and playing Gears of War. If you're just tuning in, that's what the stream is today. Flame and Queso and others I'm seeing asking about Dragon Prince. I haven't watched a lot of that yet.
I watched the first episode of that. And I was really, like, that sent me down a Google rabbit hole. Like, is my Netflix messed up? Because it looks really rough. And then, like, the first thing I saw was, like, yeah, they're aware of like people's reaction to the animation style, because it looks very
stilted.
It's like 3D, yeah. But yeah, it's like the 24 frames a second or something, and so it looks really weird. And they're like, we're working on it. So I was like, oh, okay, I guess I'll wait for the second season. Maybe they'll patch the show or something, and then that never happened. So I ended up not watching the rest of it.
Yeah,
but that was before I'd even watched Avatar. So now I do want to go back to it, because there's like talent from Avatar.
Yeah. I guess I'm just gonna break down all these trees. I don't know, so I can see.
Being attacked by trees.
Like I can't even see any bad guys. See that guy. See that guy. There we go. Seeing some things now. Like I'm seeing the little things pop up over their head, but I can't see them.
I think I'm just closer to them to where they spawn, so I can mark them.
Well, how do you mark them? Like I see
if
the
you just hold, if you just hold the left trigger over their head long enough, it'll automatically
mark. Okay. You know, I like this, now that I understand how the trees work, I think that's a cool idea of like basically cover popping up because of the lightning. I think that's cool. Wait, is Jack opening the door, or that we have two Jacks?
Well, he drops a little shock trap off. I'll take that.
I see like an invisible dude flying around though.
Right. So like, the thing he's using to cut open the door is separate from himself.
Oh, okay. That's cool. The grenades actually react to the storm.
The guy coming up on our left.
I don't want this gun. I want hammer burst. Now I'm out of hammer burst.
We'll get more hammer burst.
I'm gonna use this rifle. I don't like rifles.
This'll work.
The door's open! Let's get our asses inside! Let's go!
There's hammer burst ammo over here if you need it.
I got it. Right. John Michael Higgins says, Michael and John, you dude, that's who we're thinking of.
He's great.
He's in everything and he's always great.
Okay, skiff's not much farther.
Alright. We might be able to finish this chapter today.
That's the important part.
And I think if we go extra, maybe if we go extra long tomorrow, we might be able to finish the other act. But we'll see how that goes.
Yeah, it's not a big deal.
There's only two chapters in Act 4, so.
Now that we've proven.
Come on, let's check on the skiff.
Okay, Fox, grab the other side.
Mike Lynch on YouTube talking about Star vs. The Force of Evil's theme song. It's amazing. It's the best animated children's television show theme song since Ninja Turtles. I stand by that.
Wow. Those are big words, Kyle.
Pretty good at this military leadership thing.
Hot take, I guess.
Yeah, probably why you're good at it. When we're done showering the corporal with compliments, we should decide whether we're headed straight back to the airfield or not. Faz is right.
All the skiff is all the way out there.
Fortunately, it doesn't happen often. So there's one thing I don't get. This wasn't UIR territory originally. So
wait, where are we supposed to be? Like, all the way around?
Where'd you go?
Oh, wait, there's the... Oh.
Yeah, we're going to the...
Oh, okay, I see where I got confused. The microchip.
Of course, while we were making the world a more... Hopefully it doesn't freak out on me.
Hopefully it works as it's supposed to.
Oh, just use a cutscene. And said, oh,
hello. We'll take that. Piss that was off, weird. Thanks. Why did? I mean, what was that about? The easiest possible place to build your super weapon, right along your enemy's border.
Brilliant, really.
This skiff is weird. It just seems like a bad design that the person on the back steers it the way they do? I don't know.
It just seems weird for them to have a thing, like the secondary person basically doesn't do anything.
Yeah.
It definitely feels like they had something planned.
Alright, I guess we're going the right way. I'm looking at the map. I mean, you want to take a left whenever you can.
Yeah.
Oh, what's going on? I was looking at the map, I just heard like a big crunchy crash.
No, that was me jumping off the edge. Just seeing walls here. Am I going the right way?
Yeah, you're going the right way. I mean, according to the map. Gal's got Moxie talking about She-Ra on Netflix. Another good animated show. I've been watching that with the family.
Just a couple episodes of that. I'm into that.
What'd you say?
I watched a couple episodes of that. Yeah.
Yeah, good. It's good. I like it.
Park the skiff as close as you can. I think it's kind of heavy. And so we meet again.
Is this the right place? Well, here's some.
Yes, I mean, abandoned airport.
Yeah.
Can we get through here?
Yeah, we might have to go around. Okay. Well, that's weird.
Feels like we should be able to hit those, just knock over those sandbags and walk.
Yeah. Kind of walk in between there.
Yeah, is there like another entrance or something? I guess you're like looking around the edge, see if there's another.
Okay.
Oh, here we go. That's easy now. Assuming this is the right way. I mean, it feels like the right way.
Yeah. They won't let us go past the plane.
Oh. Thing to Baird.
Lead the way. Paddock, where's Baird?
In back. He was explaining to me the new modification he made for your little pot frame. It was boring, so I came out here.
We should probably unload this targeting beacon ASAP.
And you think that's going to save the world?
This guy has no optimism.
Excellent. I'll meet you around back.
It's like we're just trying to do something, man.
If Bear's going back to New Ephira with the beacon, how are we getting back?
Like, you can either help or get out.
Oh, no. Didn't you crash your basic training?
Oh, I had a slight miss.
How you doing the ammo? There's, like, ammo everywhere.
Otherwise known as a crash.
Doing okay.
Set that targeting beacon down. I'll deal with it in a bit. Gladly.
What's this thing? I want it. Give it me.
Get it later, honey.
Hey, here. Can we talk?
Yeah, listen, kid. You still got a rocket to launch, and I need to get back to New Ephira.
Yeah, right. Of course.
JD, we're fine. I'm just working through it. We can talk later.
I appreciate that. Thanks.
I should probably know what they're talking about, right? But I'm not sure what they're talking about.
Yeah. New and improved shield,
it's a new and improved shield prototype for Jack.
Now I can get the thing.
It's time for the thing.
The module, please. Anytime now.
Cool.
Installed. Tell us about it.
It's actually very interesting. First, it creates an ionized vector.
That was pretty funny. I like that.
Here's the tutorial on how to use it. Actual place, yeah. Oh. There's a guy there.
Success! On the very first test, too!
Wait, you never tested it?
Can I shoot through the shield?
So, oh, maybe you can.
like a dude from Overwatch whose name I can't remember.
Yeah, I feel like at some point people decided that barriers aren't fun because you can't shoot through them, so everyone just
decided.
Yeah.
What if you made all barriers that you players use one-sided somehow, even though it makes very little sense?
Yeah, it does not make sense, but it's fun. Oh, shooting my friend. Oopsie.
You come into my house uninvited. You pay the price.
Incoming frag!
I keep reloading my dumb weapon without needing to, because the clips are so big. Arnor, cover!
Oh.
Are you down?
No, JD is. I'm about to be.
Freaking JD.
I'm down, and there's three guys that who can revive me.
You got it? You all good?
Yeah.
Get to the tarmac before
Bear
loses his ride home.
Get to the tarmac.
They're right on top of us.
We're
gonna clear this tarmac or Bear's not going anywhere.
Come on down to Durlap.
A couple folks asking about that Mario Kart review. That's on IGN. You can find that on IGN. And thank you for the kind words about it. I opened that game today, and I had saved up a bunch of crystals to do 10 unlocks at once. And I unlocked Baby Mario 3 times in a row, so...
But now you have 3 Baby Marios?
Yeah. But it's like that thing, you know how mobile games are. Like, if you unlock multiples, it increases the strength of the one, you know. So
like
it's not like,
Baby Mario.
Yeah, it's not like a total loss or anything, but it was like, come on, man, like, give me, like, a new person. Like, I don't want Baby Mario 3 times. It's dumb.
Like, on its face, like, the idea of a mobile Mario Kart sounds really cool, but, yeah, the way they've monetized it is kind of...
Thankfully, the actual racing part, which, you know, arguably is the important part, I feel is pretty fun and works pretty well.
All the helicopter, blades here.
Oh, you can get killed by those?
Yeah.
Are they trying to mess up our skiff? What are they doing?
Looks like they want you to stay.
I'm shooting them. They're not going to mess up my skiff. Only the game's glitches can mess up the skiff.
I don't see any other bad guys. Oh, there's one. Oh, he's a big, strong guy.
Jack, shut up! Yeah, there's no cover there, so I tried to push through, but it... He's blinded.
It's funny, he's just kind of like...
My plan was to just get my big gun and run at him. Didn't work.
Why isn't my plan working?
Stay down.
It was flawless.
Okay. Bear feels secure. No bear can get taken out of here.
Come on. We still have to do in this bloody desert.
All right, Delta. Back on the skiff.
What else do we have to do? We did everything, I assume.
Maybe just get in the skiff, right? Step back out on the skiff. Yeah. Then just keep going.
So, are we back on task then? Let's hope so.
Where are we going?
Just keep going that way. Keep going the way you were. But I think eventually an icon pops up.
Okay.
I had the same problem when I played.
Alright.
Uh-oh.
Alright, I assume I'm heading the right direction. This feels right.
Yeah. Very bad.
Oh. Oh, wait. Was I supposed to go down there?
Yeah, it was the other way.
Down here, right?
Yeah.
Seems right.
See that? Smoke up ahead.
Here's a hole big enough for us to get through.
How convenient.
Let's get in there and see what we can do.
Look, they're still fighting. We gotta help them.
Oh, it's one of those guys. There's a couple of them. Is there a hammer burst here? A boom shot, let's see. I'm almost dead, but I wanted to grab the boom shot.
Well, there's two of them, so you can use it on him. Oh, he's countdown. Okay.
You alright?
The one that fought. Yeah. Jack helped me out.
Alright, that's all the boom shots. How many of these things are there?
Well,
three
so far.
Oh, there's boom shot ammo, like, right under that thing. excuse me while I just pick that up from under your feet.
Did you move? Thank you.
There we go.
My last shot, that thing died. We're clear. Now I'm out of ammo.
I speak in Russian. Oh, in Vesgari. Excuse me.
You hearing this?
He says the beacons are safe. I'll send someone to pick them up now. And don't worry. They'll be well armed. So go. Deal with your rocket.
All right. Delta out. All right. We're done here. Let's get back on the skiff.
Just to be clear, beating down Brian, talk about that little thing I wrote for PC Gamer. It wasn't a full review, it was just like, sort of, hey, check this thing out. Like, I just, it's not a scored review. It was,
impressions, right?
Yeah, impressions, closer to a preview.
It's time to put that rocket together.
Sounds good to me. What about Paddock's Nomads?
They have stuck their necks out for us.
That doesn't look like it.
Maybe we own something for that. Sure, but if we don't get our rocket launched soon, it's not just Paddock's Nomads we'll be worrying about.
Mike Lynch on YouTube talking about Amazing World of Gumball, another fantastic animated show. Always really makes me laugh, genuinely.
Yeah, that's one of the shows that I've seen mostly through clips.
Yeah.
And all those clips have always been good, so.
There's a great episode that just fully, like, the whole premise of the episode is just sort of a parody of Final Fantasy and, like, Final Fantasy VII even specifically, and it's really great, the whole thing.
Yeah. We were talking about this in the office when it happened, but there's that This American Life episode.
Oh, yeah.
Spent, like, the whole first act talking about Final Fantasy VII and the death of Aeris.
Yeah. So bizarre. My sister messaged me about that, and I quickly went and listened to it, and just to hear Ira Glass talk about
try to explain Final Fantasy VII to it, like, an audience that could not care less about video games.
Yeah, it's super weird.
That's always
funny.
The most fascinating thing to me. It's like, what do people who aren't mired in this stuff think about video games, and how do they understand them? That was like really eye opening to see. Like, okay, there's some they're using some concepts, but they're obviously not going to use like, oh yeah, it's turn based, it's RPG, it's got materia in it.
Yeah,
they're going to focus on like.
You go on an adventure, you know.
Yeah. Like, the mechanics are in a lot of ways irrelevant to a lot of people, and they're just interested in what the story that the game is telling.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, that was a good a good episode of This American Life. And believe it or not, some people got upset about how...
they talked about it?
How they talked about their hobby, which I thought he was being perfectly polite and nice.
Yeah. You don't understand, she was my girlfriend.
She's all I had.
Surprisingly not terrible having you alone.
We have another shootout here?
The marker's like way up high. I don't know,
yeah,
up there.
I'll have to get back in here.
Probably call it a stream pretty soon here.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, I was hoping to finish it, but I guess I underestimated how...
I mean, I don't know. How close are we? Should we...
I think there's one more segment that we might have to go through, but don't quote me on that.
No, we can go for another. As long as you're game, you want to go for another, like, 15...
Yeah,
minutes,
I should be okay then, yeah. You're about to leave the desert and will not be able to return. We might... Yeah, this might be actually a good place. If I remember correctly, there's one more gunfight, and then maybe we can do it, but up to you.
Yeah, let's do it.
Get the other side. Okay. It's time to finish this.
It'd be nice to have a nice stopping point, you know.
Paddock, we're back at the hangar. Everything should be ready.
Does anyone know how much longer we have? I feel like I want to say this is maybe one or two more encounters left, but I could be totally wrong about that.
Yeah, let's know.
What do you want from me? I can barely turn on a computer. Go press the button and see what happens.
Oh boy. Alright, got a door with a handprint on it.
Alrighty.
And there we are. Everyone's favorite rocket.
Let's get down to the platform and... throw a switch.
Yeah, see what happens.
Just gotta get out there.
Hey, where's the button? Oh, there we go. Okay. We started the game by launching a rocket, didn't we?
Yeah. Now we're back at it again.
Here goes nothing.
Can't stop, won't stop launching rockets.
Paddock, our rocket's assembly.
Look out! There's a bloody snatcher in here.
Son of a bitch.
Gal's got Moxie. Hi to your daughter. He says hello to me. And Suriel.
Hello. Beatdown Brian says we have about 10 minutes left.
Okay, yeah, we can finish this up then.
Kate, you got this.
Oh, I was running over to where I thought it was, but then I popped up right behind me. Back over to you guys.
Oh boy.
Are you down?
No, you need help. Is that you over there?
Oh, second snatcher just got me.
Oops.
I think he's about to eat me.
Someone save me!
There's three
save
people
us.
Down.
Alright, I'm up.
I'm getting eaten. So you might want to shoot
can
the...
I? Okay.
Yeah, if you shoot it enough, I think I'll come.
So yeah, well, here's the problem. Here's the rub.
Uh-huh.
I don't have any ammo.
Oh, okay.
I have...
Right.
Oh wait, hold on, I got my bolt hog. There we go. Okay, I forgot about that. I never use the sort of handguns, so like, I always forget about
them. Revive our others.
Are you out? Oh,
yeah,
I'm down.
I'm out.
Okay. I got eated. Let's see if
all
we can get out of this. Oh, I'm alive. Okay.
Well, now I'm down.
Alright, well, I'll try to come get you.
Now he's gonna come over to eat and
okay,
eat
now
eat.
I'm down
oh, okay.
again.
Alright.
Alright, I'm up again. Alright, let's see.
Hopefully you guys can shoot him enough.
And where are you? Are you inside the thing?
I'm inside the thing. Okay, so I'm popping out now.
Okay, I died.
Okay.
I don't know what hit me. Are there things other than those bosses in there?
Yeah, there were three guys.
Okay.
That was I ran up too far ahead. I should have slow down. I didn't know. I thought I was making my way over to where it was, not, and I ran right past it. So
I exploded.
That whole cavalcade of errors was on me.
I didn't help. All right, we're
just
gonna
constantly, if someone was down, but
we're gonna do this right this time.
Yeah,
we're gonna think this through. We're gonna come in with less than 38 bullets and 3 boom shots.
I wonder if there's any ammo.
Someone said in the chat, there's Beating Down Brian says ammo in the small rooms. So, okay, yeah, so. Not much, though. Alright, well, whatever. It's a start. Should we focus on just one of these guys?
Probably best.
You want the guy on the left, maybe, just to kind of arbitrarily decide?
Yeah.
And there's lots of explosive.
Get over here! You shoot me.
What hit me?
They both have those little stingers that they can throw off that'll deal a ton of damage.
Oh, okay. Oh, now that was some noise. Are you down? Need help?
No. So, one of the AIs. Now I'm down. But I'm right next to an AI.
Oh, I'm down.
Okay, one of them's dead.
Okay, cool.
Where are you? Kate, you got this.
So I need more ammo. Let's see. I have some boom shots, but that's it. Where is the other guy? I don't even see him.
There's a couple of boomer guys coming in here.
Okay, yeah. So it seems like the little rooms generally have ammo in them. I just got some.
Do you see the other snatcher?
Yeah, he's like on the right corner. Like, oh, for some reason I feel dumb. I thought that you guys were over here with me. I didn't realize there were other. I thought we were just fighting the bosses.
Well, the JD just ran right past me, even though I was down.
I messed up. Okay. That one was on me, because I went back in the corner by myself, and there were, like, there were guys other than the big monster dude, the snatcher thing.
Yeah.
So I won't do that again.
Okay.
We'll stay back. We're going to fight these guys. We're going to do it.
We can do it.
All right. There is more ammo around here. Let's see. Oh, here's a long shot. I guess I'll take it. Seems better than the boom shot at this point. Yeah. I did drop a boom shot over there. If you want to go get it. So, what the heck? Jesus. Guy on the left, right? Is that what we're thinking?
Yep. Yeah.
Yeah, come in.
First one's almost down.
Alright, I'm out of long shot ammo. Go get my. Jeez.
One of them's down.
I'm down. I'm back. I kind of went backwards to try to get the boom shot ammo that I left behind.
There's.
Are you down, or is that?
No, there's just a few guys.
I'm basically like, I'm only worrying about reviving you if you're. You know, I'm not worried about the AI. Yeah. You know. Ah, crap, I'm down.
I'm coming.
This boom shot is gonna be the death of me, man. Jeez.
Oh, you gotta shoot this guy. Okay, once we take care of the second guy, I think we should be good. We just gotta.
Yeah. How's its health level at? Alright, I'm completely out of ammo now, so I gotta go try to hit up one of those little rooms, maybe.
I'm down.
You're down? Where are you?
I'm about to get eaten by the guy. Yeah. Shoot him.
I don't have any
ammo. He's almost dead anyway.
Yeah. Alright,
dead?
Yep.
Okay.
Got one guy over there down, but he's on the other side of the line of fire.
Whoa, jeez. I just like exploded.
Oof. All right, we got this. We can do this. We just have to stick together.
Yeah, we just keep getting separated. I just, yeah,
just like whenever we have to run really far to revive somebody, that's when things start falling apart.
Beating down Brian says I should upgrade Jack's pulse so it can revive. Let's see. Yeah. All right. Let me see if I can upgrade that stuff. What was the pulse in particular?
Yeah, the pulse or the stim? I think it should tell you. Let's see.
Jack is very boost. Revive. Okay. Oh yeah, there we go. Cool.
Alright, cool. So we can just use that then.
Yeah.
No reason not to play it safe though.
Alright, there we go.
Play safe, right?
So I'm kind of staying back here because I got the long shot.
He's always just gonna catch me. Oh,
trying to use up all this long shot ammo. What? Jeez. I got it. I'm like way in the back. I know we were talking about sticking together, but.
Alright, I'm heading back towards you.
Don't you die, JD is coming towards me. Alright. I just wanted to make sure I used all the boom shot and the long shot ammo and stuff, you know?
Shoot the other guy, because, he's got him.
Gotcha! Alright. There we go.
Are you down?
I am not down. I'm good.
Sweet.
You're staying back, right? You're not like, are you?
I'm trying to get. I'm trying to get him because he keeps getting sucked in.
Yeah. Oh, Foz. Okay, so jeez. Yeah. All right.
So you don't have any ammo then?
I mean, no, when we start, no, not really.
Okay.
Like, there's a long shot, and I go use that, and I have, like, boom shot, and then I kind of have to go get ammo, you know, at that point.
Just so I get, like, these weird hitches that basically pause the game for, like, 2 seconds, so that makes it hard to react sometimes. I don't know why. I don't know if it's just, like, I have a weird install or something, but...
Alright, so...
Here, maybe I can swap the... Here.
Do you want to do the long shot?
Yeah, I can do long shot, and then you take the claw, which does have ammo in it.
Okay. Yeah, I'll just leave the boom shot here.
There's more rifle ammo, so I should be able to use that then.
Alright, so still just focusing on the one on the left first, right?
Yeah.
Is its tail a weak point too? I hadn't considered that. Where it's like glowing yellow, glowing orange.
I think that's just to let you know it's about to fire, but I could be wrong. Okay.
Help me! There we go. So how do we get Jack to revive us? Or is Jack reviving himself?
You gotta use the pulse.
Okay, we got the one.
I'm down right next to you.
Okay, I'm coming. Oh, did he get you? Ah, crap, I'm down. Okay, but you're out, though, right?
I can copy.
Okay, sweet. Boom shot over here.
Down again.
Are you inside?
Are you beating me?
Are you out?
He's dead, yep.
Okay. Where are so now we guys? Just have the other yep. guys, right? Okay, so I just need to find a good cover spot. Is that you? Is that down?
No. I'm grabbing.
Just hitting this dude with frag grenades. Ah, crap.
Got blown up.
Ugh. What happened?
It seems like everyone's down. Like, they have so many ways to just instantly down us. I'm not sure. Like, we have to kill those things, like, super quickly before those guys come. Otherwise, things just get so much harder.
Yeah. I mean, I feel like we're doing it well.
Yeah, I feel like we're doing okay. It's just, like...
Because we're getting those guys taken care of quickly.
They pounce on us so quickly.
Okay. Do you want... I mean, I'm good with just, like, grabbing... I'll grab the long shot here, and I'm going to stay back here.
All right.
And focus on the one on the left when it comes up. Okay, that's it for long shot.
Okay, first one's almost down. Okay, first one's down.
Oh, he's already down?
Yeah.
Ah, jeez. I don't know how it hits me way back here. We got science. Is Foz coming to get me?
On my way.
There we go. All
right, well, now they're here.
Jeez, and he's like way back there.
I guess shoot the boomers guy. I'm down.
Where are you?
Yeah, I see you. Hold on.
Spread out.
Get over here. Is there any more? There's a decent amount of like explosive barrels and stuff.
Yeah. Don't feel super great about it. There we go. Hold on.
Alright, I need a gun of some kind here.
This'll work.
Alright, so I'm staying pretty far back just in general. Jeez. I don't know if you're doing the same thing.
I'm pretty close to you, yeah. Okay, so I think we're about to get one of them down.
Crazy, because this time there's the other monster who's still just chilling over there. Who I don't think has eaten anybody or anything, right?
No, he's just gonna... Alright, we got this guy.
Crap, I'm out of ammo. Oh. Let's see. Are you down?
No, but he's right on top of us.
Crap. Alright, I need help.
JD's
coming. JD's coming. Don't worry.
Throwing grenade. Frag out.
Shooting him.
There we go.
Is that it? Oh no, they're still.
Stay down.
There we go.
All right. Did it.
We got them all.
We gotta get on that gantry and realign the nose cone.
Let's see.
That'll work.
Trying to grab some ammo here.
Jack, you gotta realize this thing, buddy.
I'm just like running around grabbing ammo just because I'm so low.
Right.
Yeah. I'm on solo.
Yeah.
Do you need me for anything to progress? Are we just waiting on Jack or something?
We're trying to reset the fallen gantry, but I told Jack to come here and do it, but he didn't. Not listening.
Here, where are you?
He's over with you, it looks like.
Do I have to do it? As player
no,
one?
I think I can do it. I'm.
Maybe I just have to be on here.
Yeah, he just has to be on the gantry.
All right, we're back in business.
Then climb aboard the rocket. You can ride it straight to the launch pad.
They come in like a nice little path here.
All right. Easy All right. Enough. Objective fulfilled. We took out the swarm. Storm's over, guys.
We did it. Wait, we're standing on the rocket? What are we doing? The thing's going to space. I don't think you guys want to be on there.
No, by our standards, that counter would overshoot.
I don't know about him like tackling the thing and it being enough to topple it completely.
Yeah. I don't know, it's windy in there, you know.
That's true. Maybe
they're moving real fast.
People are firing off bad jokes in the chat.
Holy shit. Fast. Hey. Thank you.
They're gonna help him?
I'm moved by your gratitude, really, I am. But I remind you, I'm hanging from the back of a fucking train. Oh, right.
A what train? Oh, is it, you know, it just occurred to me, because I have my profanity, like, bleeped, so to speak. Is yours doing the same thing? Or is it, did he drop?
My audio is the same.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, sweet. Okay. This will be a good place to stop when this cutscene's over. What if we just stop right now? Okay. Uh-oh. Is that something we gotta fight later?
This one's pretty quick, but yeah, we should probably just do it tomorrow.
All right, rocket delivered. What now? Well, now we raise it into position.
Manually, from the looks of it.
Which means we need to find the control room.
Yeah, initiate launch.
And then head back to base.
Ugh, bloody hell. No one told me hanging with you lot would be so much work.
Oh, Foz.
He's got sunglasses on. So he's cool. And he's got an accent, so he's cool.
And he's hanging from the back of a train.
Okay, well, the UIR definitely didn't design this with the Jack interface in mind. All right, Jack, go ahead. Don't be shy.
That looks complicated.
I don't know how any of this works. I'm just doing my best.
Okay, this is what's supposed to happen.
Yeah, what's going on?
Doesn't make it any less weird.
Thank you.
Oh, they're in the thing. It's the thing's doing the thing. Okay.
Yeah. That's a good way of putting it.
There you go. One rocket successfully raised.
Paddock, need some spot translation.
Wait a minute. You initiated launch?
Were they not supposed to do that? I thought that was the whole thing they were trying to do.
Maybe.
Then get the hell out of there now!
Well, limit Suriel, is this just a sprint out of here?
No, there's a boss.
All right.
It's basically a boss fight, so. Well, it wouldn't take too long, but yeah, I gotta go set up for my stream.
Okay, yeah. So we'll pick this up back tomorrow. I'm sure the checkpoint will be solid. So, yeah. Cool. All right. Well, hey, thanks so much, man. Thanks everyone for tuning in. Yeah. And go watch Suriel's stream now.
Yeah, I'll be back at around 1 p.m.
A clever cadaver.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yep.
All right.
All right.
Thanks, everybody. Bye.
See ya.